Okay guys, we're back. I just wanted to get myself a drink because my mouth was getting dry after recording that last video. Alright, so yeah, we're on a roll here. We're just plowing through the Earth Temple. So anyway, we got ourselves the treasure chart. The first of two, because there's always two per dungeon, apparently. So we'll check that once we get outside of the Earth Temple, see what we get for that. Alright, so Medley, you're going to be coming with me through this door over here, and now that we've got the small key, we can just go through this right here. Yeah, she can just launch herself up like that, and then I have to take the long way, unfortunately, because I don't have wings. The only wings that I have is a sad excuse of Deku Leaf. That's all I have, man. That's all I have. You got these flashy, cool, awesome-looking wings, and then I just got the freaking Deku Leaf, and you probably laugh at me. Wow, that's so embarrassing. Okay, wait, hang on a second. Let me get my ice arrows out before you kill me. Or kick my ass, not kill me. Yeah, I don't expect you to kill me. Well, at this rate, yeah, I guess. So, man, what the heck is going on here? I can't see crap. I'm being burnt. I'm Z-targeting the wrong enemies because I can't kill the pose, man. Not with arrows. Dude, I'm not calling Medley, man. Jeez. Well, I'm not sure how to explain this. I think the light that reflects off my instrument can be redirected using a shield link. Do you think this could prove useful? I hope you're not offended by my suggestions. I just want to be helpful. No, dude, why would you offend me? I mean, that's a pretty cool suggestion. I guess stuff we've already been doing anyway. Okay, alright, okay, I guess I've now been possessed in the midst of our conversation. Let me just try and... Why is my mirror shield on? Okay, there's a soft spot, obviously, to this. Why is it when I turn this way, it works? That's weird. Yeah, get out of here. Alright, so, yeah, we need to get rid of these statues here. I'm just gonna see if I can get any refills on things like hearts and stuff. Rupees, that's cool. Okay, so for some reason, I don't know why, but every time I turn, it just doesn't seem to work. So I don't get how... That's really annoying. Is there a soft spot to this? Because hers seem to just... Oh, you know what, screw this crap. Medley's taking up like 99.9% of the screen. All you can see is just Link's eyeball. So I guess what we're supposed to do here is... Well, we can use Medley, but why can't we use Link for this? Like, why do we have to use Medley? Well, I mean, you can just do that, point that there, and then have Link redirect it to reflect on these statues instead. No, don't do that. Ugh. Why did you do that? That's not what I wanted to do. Okay. See, there's like a soft spot to this. It's really glitchy and weird. Can I get a distance on this, and hopefully... There we go. See, why is that not working now? Ugh, man, this sucks. This really blows. I wasted too much... I remember this room being a pain in the ass anyway, I really do. Because it is. I don't think I'm going to be able to hit that one. Like this one over here. I don't even know if there's anything of any importance behind it. Like, I really don't think there is, because it's not marked by a treasure chest. So if I had to guess, there really is nothing behind it. Hang on a second, I think I might just have it. If I can aim it right. It's like a that's really sensitive. It was only a magic jar, right? Okay, well, we wasted a whole bunch of time on that, too. Oh, damn it, I was being absent-minded. Sorry, Medley, I forgot about you. That was my fault. I won't make the same mistake again, but guaranteed, I probably will. Alright, so this corridor here is going to be filled with keys and re-deads. There's also a chest in here, as you can see, so it's probably hidden behind one of them coffins, tombstones, whatever you want to call it. Oh god, right, okay, surprise attack. He was close to getting me just then, so close to getting me. But not close enough. Hoping this is actually a joy pendant. I am actually hoping this time that it is, because then we'll have all our 20. But you probably think that once you collect 20 joy pendants and then you turn them in, they become completely redundant. But it turns out that they're not, because you can actually give 40 joy pendants to Nurse Marie if you want to, and she gives you something else. She gives you a hero's charm, I think. But the hero's charm is, I don't know if you would count it as a total towards your 100% completion, because for one, it's not really a very useful item, and two, it would be so close towards the end of the LP, I just don't see the point in even bothering to go for that. Because the item, the Hero's Charm is basically an item that you put on. It's kind of like the Mask of Truth, but a lot different. It doesn't let you speak to gossip stones, because there are no gossip stones in this game, but it works like a mask. You put it on, and it displays the enemy's HP. It just shows you the HP gorge, tells you how much health they have and stuff. Like I say, by the time we get that, it'll probably be near the end of the game anyway, and I'm not going to sit there freaking grinding for hours and hours off screen for 40 joy pendants, because there's just absolutely no point. It would be ridiculous and a waste of time, if anything. So, yeah, that's why I'm not going to bother. I mean, if I do get 40 joy pendants by the end of the LP, then great, but, you know, it's not like something that I can promise 100% that, you know, it's definitely going to happen. Because I most likely won't. Because you mostly get joy pendants from treasure chests anyway. It's very rare that you actually get joy pendant from an enemy drop. And in fact, I don't even know what enemies drop joy pendants. Probably Boko Boblins, if I had to assume. So I can't think of anything else. I know the Moblins don't, they drop skull necklaces. And the birds, they drop golden feathers, iron knuckle, well, darkness, they drop freaking knight's crests. Hang on a second, I need to bomb this out real quick. I was about to press the A button and throw it. I had the compulsing urge to freaking do that. I didn't. Resisted, so thank god I didn't make that mistake, otherwise we could have kamikaze'd ourselves, and that would have been very clever now, would it? Alright, so we need to go all the way down to this pit. As you can see across the other side of the pit, on the top of this room, you can see the boss door on the other side, but we still lack the boss key, so we can't actually go in there yet. I don't think there's anything noteworthy down there, so don't bother going down there. Yeah, there's no chests down there or anything, so don't bother. Right, now this room is the worst room in the dungeon, right here. You're looking at it. The worst freaking room in the entire dungeon. If there's any room that you will remember from the Earth Temple, it's this one. I like to call this the mirror room, because it's just a whole bunch of mirrors. Basically, what you have to do is get light in here somehow. I can't even remember how you do that. once you get light in here, you have to disintegrate all these statues, have all of these mirrors react to each other, and create like this whole crazy complex of mirror beams shooting left, right, and center across the entire room. But the first things first is trying to figure out exactly how to get this beam of light to shine down into the room. Because there's literally nothing that you can do in here until you get that light. So I'm just gonna have a mosey on around here and have a look and see if there is anything that we can do to make the light appear. It doesn't look like it so far. Well, hang on, there's this one we can push as well. But this probably won't do anything. I don't think it'll trigger anything. If it does, then I'll be damned, but yeah, as you can see, it doesn't do anything. You might even need to, take control of Medley here for a second. So let's do that. And we shall take flight to this thing that's protruding from the ground, the gigantic wall here that has a switch on top of it. And that's all your hatches. Okay, at least I figured that out. So now we can actually make a start on this. Ugh, man. I'm really not looking forward to this, though. Not at all. A lot of this you have to use Medley for anyway, so... it's just easier to do it with her, I think. Getting rid of these statues, definitely, is a lot easier with her. I don't know how much of this room we're gonna get done before the end of the video, but I'm hoping to get at least a great portion of it done, or at least make a decent start on it. Yeah, there's a lot of pushing and pulling and all this gobbledygook. Push this one down into here, and then that should reflect to another one somewhere else. Right, okay, so then that goes there. So what we need to do now, well actually what we can do is do this first, if I can, with my mirror shield. Maybe not, because Medley obviously wants to get all the attention. Alright, so let's grab this. You know what, we've had a pretty good run of the Earth Temple. I'm actually quite impressed with how well this has gone so far. This could have gone a lot worse, in my opinion, knowing how annoying this dungeon can be. For someone who hasn't played the game in 8 or 9 years, this is about as good as it's gonna get. So, right, I need to have a look and see where the markings are, or I might actually have to do this, put them, shine the mirror onto here, and have Link stand on that pedestal. Yeah, that's exactly what I have to do. Alright. Get rid of these shine spots. That should be another mirror that we have to pull out. But I think I'll do that in the next video, because I'm not going to have time. I just want to be on the safe side of things, so. Alright guys, I'm getting off the video here, and we'll continue on next time. So in the next episode, let's play Legend of Zelda Wind Waker. We shall traverse through the mirror room of the Earth Temple.